Okay.
Hello. So what's your name?
My name is Kramp.
And what do you do?
I'm an assistant planner with the Port of San Diego in their environmental conservation department.
Cool. What does your day-to-day look like?
So anytime somebody wants to do something in or above the water around the port tidelands, the majority of the bay that's not controlled by the Navy, it usually requires permitting through the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. We also have a regional water quality control board in San Diego, and then depending on the size, scale, or impacts of the project, we might also have to do consultations with other federal or state agencies like NOAA or National Fisheries, or we have a National Wildlife Refuge in San Diego, so there's consultations with them as well before our project can move forward. We also assist with the environmental review for those projects, so we go through an entire CEQA process, which is the California Environmental Quality Act. Every project has to be reviewed under CEQA to assess what the impacts are, and then if there are impacts, then you have to mitigate for them. So if you want to build a pier and it might change the seafloor, where eelgrass goes, eelgrass is a sensitive habitat, and then you have to mitigate for them, so you might have to plant eelgrass somewhere else. So we make sure everybody complies with those regulations, and we'll assess what all the impacts are, and we're mitigating for them. So that's the majority of what I do at the port.
What's your favorite thing to do? Or what has there been any projects that you've been really passionate about or that you've enjoyed doing?
Yeah, so permitting is not exactly a thrilling field, but the port has been exploring some new ventures, including aquaculture and food technology initiatives and mitigation baking, which are all really new ideas. They're sustainable and environmentally friendly and forward-thinking. So we're looking at ways to restore coastal wetland habitats, which is a very expensive process, and because you don't get money from the environment, a lot of people don't want to do it because it costs too much and you don't get anything in return. But if you build a mitigation base, that basically means you restore a really low quality habitat to a really high functioning quality habitat, and then you sell credits for them, which are like usually on the scale of an acre. So if you're going to develop somewhere else, you might impact the environment there, and you can buy credits to offset that. And usually the mitigation ratio is maybe like 1-4, so if you're going to develop on 1 acre, you have to mitigate for 4 acres, so it favors environmental restoration. And so that's a really great project because it benefits the environment, it's profitable, and it benefits local communities because you're helping the environment. So
that's really cool.
Yeah, it's my favorite part.
That's awesome. What would you say is the most challenging part, or the most mundane, or the least, the part of your job that you enjoy the least?
So in California, we have really strong environmental laws and regulations, which is a really great thing because it protects the environment, but it also means that getting through that process to do something like build a mitigation bank can be really tedious and take a really long time, and that can always be a struggle. So we've been working on building our mitigation bank in South San Diego Bay for really the last couple of years, and it'll probably take us at least another 2 to 5 years to get through the review process before we can even, you know, start construction. So environmental regulations are great, but a lot of
roadblocks. Yeah. Okay, cool. Thank you so much, Heather. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.
All right, well, have a great day.
You too.